recognised within our region and our listening area. Well done, Michelle. And now we're ready to start the third term, and we've got Chris Sheen about to call the ball for the third term in the preliminary final at Lancefield Park.
Great work there, Dougie, here on Highlands FM. There's a free kick too high. We'll go to the red back straight away. They're kicking the left of it all. The scoreboard in 8-11, 59, 3-7, 34 points to the good at the moment here, the Redbacks. The ball comes out to Farmer on the commentary wing up towards Dawson. Drops one there. Probably should have taken there. Laser tackle though on House. Good recovery. And we'll see a ball up. No prior opportunity. 40 metres out from goal. So Dougie probably just lacking confidence there, Dawson. But he went in there, laid the tackle and locked the ball up.
And Cam Dawson, we always have eyes on Cam because we know he's got so much ability, but he gets himself into trouble a bit from time to time, doesn't he?
Yeah, he certainly does, yes. And just checking those stats out at the halftime break. Clearance is interesting. Broadford in front, 24-16, yet trailing by over five goals on the scoreboard. Inside 50s, 29-25 in Romsey's favour. Free kicks, 11-10 in Broadford's favour, but a key one probably is Broadford giving away five 50-metre penalties. And what a start to
Connor Whelan. Just an outstanding tap down from Connor Whelan down to Chris Burkett around the body, but pushes it wide, straight across the face, out of bounds on the full. And we were saying at halftime, Chris, how good a job Connor Whelan's doing in those ruck contests.
Yeah, so he's doing fantastic. And obviously, with Cam White unavailable, he certainly stepped up in his absence. And Connor's done a fantastic job this year, switching with Whitey in the ruck, but also playing a key role down back as Pound for the Roos. Defensive end switched the ball across the outer side, and a strong mark taken there by Spark. He took a lot of those strong marks last week, Gav, in the forward line.
Yeah, it's his first one today as he switches the ball inside to Boyle, who goes back to Pound. Pound steps around lob, kicks a low worm burner up to the half back line, finds Brodie Holland.
All their key stars have stepped up in the last, just this passage of play too. They all need a lift here, Holland, Boyle, and Poundy.
Quite stagnant though.
Holland down the line, finds his teammate, centre wing, Boyle again, needs to find another target, and again, as EJ said, very stagnant up the field, kicks long towards half forward, Romanak stayed down, over the back, ball fell in his lap, kicks inside forward 50, and Bullis takes the mark on the lead up, uncontested, and we'll have a shot from 15 metres out on a 45 degree angle.
And this is the sort of shot that Bullis can kick wrong side for a left footer. But if his confidence is up and so the team, then he'll slot this one through and aim for that left-hand goalpost and watch it curl through. So that's Corey Hall, in fact, and it's a goal anyway. That's fantastic. Was it Jake Hall, number 28? Straight through the high, diddle diddle. That's Jake Hall, goes bang! As EJ's got the wrong team list. That's my fault, mate. That's it. Just don't give up your day job, mate. There you go.
No, good response from Broadford there. They needed the first of the quarter, gain a little bit of momentum, get back into the contest, and great result. A nice finish by Jake Hall, and brings Broadford right back into the contest.
The Polaro Financial Services scoreboard is back to 28 points. 3 minutes and 3 1/4 minutes gone here in this term now, as Vianney likes to work his way back out there from half back, finds a teammate by hand. Handball over the top now out to Boyle. Boyle here for Broadford. Up towards half forward in front of Heather, and it bounces away from him. Knocks back down there to Corey Hall. Up towards half forward. Strong hands. Almost taken there by Broadford. A shot at goal on its way in the goal square. This should be a soda. And it's home.
Terrific football down there by that Broadford player down in the pocket.
Yeah, it was Jake Hall.
It was Jake, was it again?
And I think it was that was Phil Pott.
Yeah, big Phil Pott.
How many goals did he kick today?
That's two. Yeah, that's this is good signs early on. They're starting to get the ball, and just there was a little bit of patience on that far side there. Yeah, they got a little bit of luck with a sort of a collision of players that led to that first goal. But then that nice movement and their good ball users getting involved. Phil Pop finishing off the top of the square. That little bit of momentum, that little bit of belief comes back again. Good start for the Broadford side here.
4 minutes gone here on the Polaris Financial Services scoreboard, and the margins cut back to 22 points. It's 37-59 here on Highlands FM, and a cracking game we've got on hands for you here today, as the ball beautifully tapped out there again from Connor Whelan out to Petrora. He turns it over to Scales across half back, switches across towards the commentary wing, taken there by Corey Hall there for Broadford. Looking for a teammate further up the field. Hugs the boundary line. Too much pebble on that. Out of bounds on the full. Free kick to Romsey just forward of centre.
Yeah, the Redbacks just need to control a little bit of momentum here, Reg.
Yeah, so they just get that little bit of tempo footy just for a minute or so. Just trying to slow the play down a little bit. Get the game back on their terms.
We got a conversation here from the umpires. It was on the full.
Yep. We're in prime position up here, but obviously they were a bit closer. 8-11 to 5-7.
Nathan Raymond goes down the line. Not a great kick. It's gone straight down to Spark, who flies. Can't take the mark. Connor Whelan did well to bring the ball to ground. Brawford to work it out. Corey Hall feeds the handball out to Scales. He goes long towards the forward 50. And took his eye off his opponent there, the Romsey defender. And Jake Hall comes up, takes the mark. Kicks a low kick inside 50, but turns it over. Matt Burkett takes a saving mark. Left foot kick up to centre back, Benny Way.
He's finding space, Gavin, Ben Way.
He'll settle.
He's been finding, looking for the space, and the Romsby are getting it to him.
Strong hands there by Chris Burkett on centre wing in front of Steve Boyle. Takes the mark. Brad Mitchell's found a bit of space. He'll end up with the football here in the lead up. Mitchell will look to drive the Redbacks forward. He looks wide and kicks out towards Phil Romerill, who's found some space. Well protected by Benny Way. Romerill goes to the middle with a shocker. Benudo comes in, but Nathan Tazari does well, cleans it up. He shovels the ball out. He's been picked for a throw.
And the umpire not in control of that contest there. Daryl Hodges in prime view of that one. To pay the free kick as Josh Pound sends the ball out towards the outer wing, finds Wern. That's up and under kick in hope, but it might pay off for him there. Ball there at half forward. In their chance there, Brawford back out to Wern. Back towards the outer wing. Goes on his opposite foot. That's his left foot. Inside the forward 50. Ball hits the deck. Romsey should clear across half back here. Under a bit of pressure though. Good work there. I think that was Nathan Nazari under the pressure on the outer side. Here's a chance for Romsey to clear now through O'Sullivan. Steadying now, left foot kick from Matt Burkett, looking for lob. That's what we need from the great man. Marks in front of Biani, so someone just a little bit shorter than the great man. Lob, Spark there for Brawford. He is a loose man inside that forward 50, and his name will be all over this. He should mark every day of the week. Drops the mark, good spoil there from Petroro. Boyle kicks and they're away.
And Wern takes the mark right on centre wing, turns to play on straight away. Right foot kick just chips over the top to Biani on the run. Down to half forward, he'll look inside forward 50. Romanak on the lead, comes up at the football, bounces past him. Romerill cleans it up. He handballs out wide, but again, good recovery from Brawford. Squares the ball up at Vianney into the centre of the corridor. And we've got players just piling on top of the ball inside the centre square, and we'll have a bounce.
7.5 minutes gone here. Third term, Harlan's FM football. Brawford 5-7-37, Romsey 8-11-59.
Need two or three quick goals, Brawford, DJ.
Spark smashes the ball forward, comes off for the ruse. Jazz Webb goes onto his left foot, puts it to the top of the square. Felpot! Strong, takes the mark.
He's a big man to handle down there for the Romsey forward line. And playing a bit deeper, I noticed he's pulled the old bandage off his thigh since halftime. He's just playing deep forward, pretty much hasn't gone into the ruck so far. And this is a chance for his second of the quarter. And Broadford's third goal of the third quarter.
Of course, Highlands FM, Harry McWinery, player of the day last Sunday. In the win over the Bombers, no one got near him. Philpott, question back, because he's got it. The Redbacks, they're in trouble now as Brawford, they've kicked the last four goals of this contest. At the 26-minute mark of the second term, they led by 40 points. We're 8.5 minutes into the third. The margins dwindle back down to 16.
Yeah, it's been a really good start to this third quarter, and all their prime movers are getting involved, Brawford. And getting on the end of a couple there, Philpott. He's a dangerous man. He's a big man. He's a hard man for any side to match up on when he's playing deep inside that forward 50. And they're looking dangerous at the moment. They're winning enough of the footy around the ground. They're pushing the ball inside 50, and the conversion rate is really good.
And very important that Adam Strark stand up so that Phil Pop can stay around that goal square down there, given that he's not 100% fit.
Rucks a goal up. Spark wins it down the ground there. Brady Holland, he's dispossessed of it there by two Romsey midfielders there. Pound's working hard. And we'll see a ball up just left of centre.
I think the noticeable thing in this quarter, EJ, is the work rate of the Romsey midfield. First half, they were phenomenal. This quarter, they've been really flat-footed.
Rucks go up again. Cleared out there by O'Sullivan there for Romsey. Dribbling kick out towards Boyle there of Brawford, though, at half-back. Tucks the ball in the arm, goes on a left foot. Finds a teammate there in, I think it's Attic, who's been a bit quiet by his standards there. To Picciuto, between wing and half-forward. Who wind up on that trusty right foot of his up towards centre half forward. Players will fly.
Magnificent mark.
There to the Kangaroos.
Romanak again, he's been a real danger, real thorn to the Redbacks up forward.
He certainly has been, and he's just got to start converting. 3 points all in that first quarter. He's got to make this one, stick. He's directly in front, 35 to 40 metres out. These are the ones that good forwards have got to kick.
Inside 50s for the quarter each.
Inside 50s for the quarter, mate. 5-2 in favour of Broadford.
For a return of three straight.
If fellas like Vianney and Pound, Boyle and Webb can get their hands on the ball around the packs and out in the open, they're going to get back into this game, because they're going to give their forwards like Romanek and Philpott an opportunity for kicking goals.
Romanek pushes it right again.
For kicking goals, I said, Gavin.
Well, four behinds on the day for Romanek.
Yes.
Disappointing.
We're ticked on 10.5 in this term, back to 15 points on Highlands FM Football. It's a 6-8-44 to 8-11-59.
Quarter time in the AFL second qualifying final. Indian Fremantle 4-1-25 lead, the Sydney Swans 1-6-12.
So they are Swans.
Still got their first half goal kicking problems over in Subi.
Yep. Well, they need Buddy Franklin in there, that's for sure. As Chris Burke can't there for the Redbacks up towards half back. Good spoil there from the Kangaroos. Keeps the ball inside the field of play. Right foot kick inside the forward 15. They're on here. Broadford with a shot at goal on its way. And that's a minus score. Was that Boyle
Stevie
again?
Boyle, yeah. But Broadford are just lining up here. And we spoke about it in the last quarter, Ege, about pinning the opposition inside their defensive 50. And yep. Broadford have been able to do that in this quarter. Yeah, and they're lining up now.
Yeah, exactly right. They have been. And a guy that, even when they weren't going that well in that first half, Grant Wern, he is a fantastic footballer. And he's getting his hands on the footy in this quarter as well.
Yes, Grant Werney, a photograph of him in the Weekly Times in the football supplement this week in the game between Riddle and Broadford.
As Romsey across half back led this one by 40 points not too long ago, and the Roos, they've gone on, they've kicked four goals, they kicked the last 4-2 of the contest, 3-2 to nothing in this term after leading by 34 at half times. Vark brings the ball down the ground there. Taken there by the other Kangaroos. Good tackling there by Romsey on the outer side. Under enormous pressure there, Chris Burkett works his way out of traffic. Puts the ball up net away.
Chris Burkett, terrific.
Ben Wade gets on in left foot, puts it towards space there. He saw Farmer running. He laid the bump, not the tackle. What's the story? Unfortunately, had the teammate there to lay the tackle, and Reece Smith clears for Broadford. Gav.
Kicks up to half forward. Spark drops the chest mark. Knocks it out to Grant Wern in space. He looks inside 50. Brody Holland's got about 20 metres of space. And he takes the mark.
What's
35 metres out.
What's happened to Romsey? They've just stopped.
Yeah, just flat-footed at the moment. And although we wouldn't write this one down based on his kicking performance of last week, Edge.
Absolutely not, mate. Jeez. But Zvark has been really huge in the ruck in this quarter. We mentioned how good quarter we lost in the first half. But the influence he's having in the ruck and around the ground, it's allowing Philpott to play deep. And he's proven a real handful for the Romsey defence. And Brody Holland, well, he's kicked goals on some pretty big stages.
He's,
this would be
taken
this
the
is a big opportunity.
He's taking the EJ.
Yes.
It's Brady Holland. It'll fall just a few metres short. Strong mark. Yes, indeed.
Guess who?
Oh, that's not Svark.
No, it's big Philpott for his third of the quarter.
Yeah. Now, we've seen a bit of a role reversal between these two, because Svark played forward last week and Philpott played in the ruck and half back.
I think Philpott might be a bit sore with that leg, and they've decided to just play him predominantly forward.
Spot on, Gavin.
Well, it's worked out well for him, because as you said, he's just going for goal number three. But to extend
three
it further.
Three for the quarter. He's got four. He's actually got
going
three.
His fourth.
He's going for his fourth. He kicked the fourth goal in the top, deep in the timeline of the last term. So kicked four of the last five goals in this contest. And he has missed. So you can hear the Romsey fans get excited on the Blues Financial Services scoreboard. Tick 14 minutes. It's 6-10-46 to 8-11-59. So now Romsey's last goal was at the 25-minute mark through Chris Burkett. Of the second term.
Yeah, they need the ball inside their forward 50.
They need to steady him badly.
Aiden Tazari brings the ball back in, and it's not a great kick. Goes out towards Romanak. Good sport by Romerall. Pushes the ball forward. Vianney leads his opponent in the race. Ball's over. Mitch Farmer in some space now. We'll go inside forward 50 with a long kick towards Dawson. He comes out. Good tap by Dawson. Ends up with Wade. Out to Feltham. Go out the body. Goal. Big goal for the Redbacks.
And well done, Cam Dawson there. Sometimes it's just those little things there. That little tap to a teammate there to free up Feltham that went through and kicked a valuable goal on the Polaris Financial Services scoreboard. 14.5 gone here in this term. It's Romsey 9-11-65 to 6. 6-10-46, 19 points of margin.
Yeah, and that's the thing there. If you can just clear that zone, you know, Broadbent had been pinned into that inside their forward 50 for the last 5 or 6 minutes, but they managed to get it over the back and get in the hands of their dangerous players. Farmer just got a bit of a chaos ball inside 50 there. Wade Dawson all around there, and a good finish from Feltham. They really needed that one, the Redbacks, just as a steady up.
Well, certainly the Romsey now looking very dangerous inside the forward 50 again. Good courage and a lot of players at centre-half back there as Corabiani almost ran into a brick wall and still kept going there. Reece Smith dished out a handball now. Ben Way spins out of traffic. He still finds time to squeeze his right foot out towards Wally Sutton. He waited for the ball to bounce him. Good courage there, Reece Smith. Fantastic work. Working extremely hard there in the forward pocket there. Freed up Werman out to Boyle. And he's turned the ball over.
Redbacks have lifted here, boys.
Yep.
And it's sparked to life. That Philpott misses down at the other end, and the ball goes straight down the other for a goal. And now Romsey are up and about. Expect Wade to fly from behind. No, he didn't fly. He did not leave an inch off the ground. He stood there and took a strong mark 15 metres out from goal while the others fell down around him.
Just a strong mark from Benny Way. He read the ball well. As Yandy said, everyone flew, everyone fell, and Benny Wade just held his ground.
Yeah, exactly right. He just read the ball better than the rest of the players around him then. And he is usually a very good finisher, Ben Wade. And this will be two quick ones for the Redbacks just to steady him up.
And Dougie, if Philpott had to kick that goal.
Yes, that's right, and getting down the ground. But, Bajie, you're talking about courage by two players a moment ago. I thought Zach Sard was showing a fair bit of courage too with the port player coming straight for him.
That shot there from Wade. Went through for a point with 15 minutes gone here in this term. Back to 20 points.
So, well, and now we get to the stage where Broadford really need the next one again.
Well, that's why we love finals football. Reece Smith goes bang with a 70-metre kick almost out towards our wing and half back. Socket off the ground there by Brody Holland up towards the middle of the ground now. Three Romsey Redbacks around this one. They'll jet set again now. Left foot kick there from Jack O'Sullivan, looking for Felton there. His man slipped over at the crucial stage. He kept his footing. Handball over the top now. Chris Petroro, well, it was almost that. Didn't go to him too cleverly, and the free kick's been awarded. It'll go to Broadford here at half back.
Yeah, just a poor handball there from Feltham. Didn't get enough on it, and it turned the football over. Stevie Boyle will take the free kick. Right half back for the Roos. He goes long down the line, looking for Josh Pound in a one-on-one. Ball comes down, Holland read it beautifully. Peels off, kicks inside forward 50. Jake Hall gets rid of his opponent, Tazari. Butters up well, recovers, inside 50. Kick on goal. He celebrated a bit early, and it went through for a behind. And Romanak's just asking the question. I was inboard by myself there, mate. Why didn't you square it up?
Yeah, well, a chance has gone begging there for the Broadford side on the Player Financial Services scoreboard. 6-11-47 to 9-12-66 here on Highlands FM footy. Ball up towards our centre wing. Strong mark taken there by Raymond. Just backed himself well. Closer to half back. He's told to play on. Up towards Mills in front of Holland. So Romsey now. They've got, I think, Reece Smith and Svark, the little loose keys there for Broadford. Kick up towards Feltham. Both players fell over the crucial stage. Scales, good work there. Put his body on the line. And the ball goes out of bounds. We've ticked on about 17 minutes in this third term. Still 20 points of margin. Or 19 points.
Boundary throw in right in front of the Broadford's coach's box. Centre wing. Rucks will go at it. Connor Whelan against Sparks. Spark wins it down. Whelan grabbed his jumper and Spark will get the free kick just as Nathan Raymond was breaking away from that stoppage. So it's a fortuitous free kick there for the Roos as Spark plays on, goes over the top to a man that bought his own Sharon, Stevie Boyle.
Yes, he's had a good game, Gavin.
Boyle goes inside forward 50 towards Romanak, who flies. Robert Rule gets his hand on the ball, punches away. Matty Burkhead, who's worked back hard really well this quarter, sweeps a handball to Jimmy Carroll, who's gone a bit quiet back in that back half. He swings the ball out towards Mark Young. He's pushed off the ball by Zolacek. Zolacek tries to take him on. Young comes back, tackles him, slows the ball up. Grant Wern tries to feed back again towards Holland, but Nath Raymond puts pressure on and pushes the ball out of bounds for a throw-in on centre wing.
19 points of margin here, nearing on the 18-minute mark of this third term. You're listening to EJ, Gav, Dougie, and Yenny here on 100.7 Highlands FM. 9 a.m. from next week at Romsey Park, Grand Final Day. We hope to be in your company right throughout the day as Ben Way handballs over the top now to a teammate now. for over Romsey. There's a chance here for Zach Sard. He excites every time he gathers the ball. He wants to pass it off. Great work.
Magnificent.
They were queuing up there at centre, well, down the corridor. It was no way he was going to have a shot at goal.
Just phenomenal work by Zach Sard.
Absolutely magnificent play. You've got a goal back and just break the game over just through sheer pace and sheer class, and surely will lead to a Brad Mitchell goal.
He was just toying with him, EJ.
Oh, the amount of times he's just balked and danced around players today, he's just an absolutely excitement machine. He's electric to watch.
I'll tell you what, this guy has had a big game today, Brad Mitchell. Yeah. He's used the ball so well. It'll be a lovely finish for him here if he can get it.
Got it.
He does.
The Polaris Financial Services scoreboard. Romsey have kicked away again to a 25-point lead. It's 10-12-72 to 6-11-47.
That's it, mate. 25 points the margin.
Beautiful.
I think they've got about 9 goal kickers. Would that be right, Kev?
Wally Sard's got 2. Zach Sard, 1. Matt Burkett, Mitch Farmer, Ben Feldham, Chris Petoro, Ben Way, Chris Burkett and Brad Mitchell all have individual goals.
Yeah, certainly sharing them around, and just in the last 4 or 5 minutes they've managed to get their little bit of control back into this game, Romsey. Broadford were really pushing, and ever since Philpott just missed that goal from the angle about 10 metres out, it's been all Romsey since then.
Rucks go up again, Redbacks went at the ground, but it's Vark who tries to clear the ball out. Romsey's midfield starting to lift again now. It ebbed and flowed throughout the afternoon now as Raymond clears the ball here for Romsey. Looking for Ben Way like a galloping gazelle. He came from behind.
Nath Raymond's had a massive quarter for the Redbacks too here, boys.
Certainly has. Sporting one of the best mustaches you'll ever see.
As Holland feeds the ball out to Corey Hall. He has a bounce. He's under the pump. Felton runs him down. Fantastic tackle. And the Redbacks will get a free right in the middle of the ground. He's got to move it quickly, take advantage out of this one. Moves it inside forward 50. Connor Willen in space will mark. 45 metres out from goal, 45 degree angle.
Well, he's been told to go back.
Told by the crowd in no uncertain terms to go back and kick the goal.
Well, he must kick this one now to put the margin back out to 31 points to put the asset back on Broadford. He just got close to the man on the mark there, hence why it fell short and Brodie Holland marks uncontested. Defensive 12 for Broadford.
Good to see Paul Feltham with that chase a moment ago. Troy Scoble highlighting that Romsey are not good chasers. They're not good in transition.
Dudo, dangerous kick into the middle of the ground, but it might work with Cesare fumbles. Justin Webb cleans it up, has a bounce through the middle.
He's got Matt Burkett on him.
He kicks inside forward 50 to Spark on the lead. He spills the mark, comes out the back. Spark goes back and gets it. Jimmy Carroll sits on him. That's holding the ball up higher. And it is. Jimmy Carroll will take the free kick. In defensive 50 for Romsey.
You just think if Romsey get the next goal the next few minutes, it's 21 minutes into this term, then Broadford have got a massive uphill battle against them. And I can't see that Bruce having much of an advantage at all, but the momentum will be a telling factor as Romsey across half back, switch out towards Braden Felton, marks in front of Duggan. Duggan's been pretty quiet by his standards. Felton to Petroro.
He's another one who's been very quiet.
But he can turn the game on its head. Up towards half forward now, Ben Way ricochets back in front of him now. He's got a few men in support there. Aaron Patterson, he's taken down now as Bryson Scales. He's opposite 26, wins the ball from half back, sends the ball up towards Romanek. Umpire, did he call play on? Yes, he did. Sidesteps Petroro. Geez, how many people can say they've done that in their time? Yeah. And hit up a target in the same process at the 22-minute mark. Broadfield have a shot at goal. They trail this one by 25 points.
Really well done by Romanak then. Just controlled the football, got around a couple of opponents and a beautiful kick inside to Spark on the lead.
It was under pressure too. And Spark, this is surely right in his range. He'd be 45, almost 50 he'll be kicking from.
Romanak and Rom are all having a, well, pulling edge, getting involved in a bit of indiscretion behind play. Spark, big lovely kick. It'll just fall a little bit short. I think it was Lobb thought he had it before he spent it. Ball 25 metres out from Broadford's goal. It's taken there by Romsey. That's Burkett of the Matt variety.
Here
out
comes
towards
the magic, guys.
Zach Sard, he turns on a show. Inboard now. Just through the legs there. Well, you're right.
Bold.
Yeah, there you see it. There you don't. Turnover now. Chris Petroro. He's got Farmer out of the corner of his eye. Good work there from Patterson. Just freeing up the space
all
there.
All the Broadford numbers behind the ball, though.
Yes, a lot of there. That's why Mitch decided to hold it up.
Well, that's probably where you need a Petroro running past. Instead, he will go bang. No, he won't. He'll switch it across the outside.
Great kick.
Lob. Marks 40 metres out from the other side. He found space there where there was none.
He was just patient there, Mitch Farmer. Yes. Didn't overcook. Could have gone down the line where Philpott was just sitting in the goal square, but instead just lifted the eyes, opened the field up to for himself by just carrying the football for a little bit and finds lob about 40 out.
And that's what separates the really good players, just that composure, you know.
A lot of players had that patience,
he had
lob and
lob far away,
and he
could be
set down the final
thing.
So
up
to the top of the square, the player flies, Gales, flies highest and takes a great mark.
Umpire's paid the mark, and we have a little bit of a push of chub in there now, but it'll be a free kick to Bryson Scales. While he's hard getting involved, he's going to give away a 50 here if he walks through the mark. I don't know why he hasn't given away a 50. He's still there.
It's that's a
if
problem.
He wants to get involved in a push and shove, it's a 50-metre penalty. As Scales goes long towards half-back, and he hits the deck, handball feeds wide towards Farmer. Heatherton does well, shoves him off the footy, gets a quick kick, but Robsy is set up behind the ball again. Jimmy Carroll feeds a handball to Mills. Mills, under the pump, feeds a handball backwards towards Dazari. He looks into the middle of the ground, Chris Burkett in space. He takes the mark, right in the centre of Lancefield Park. Kicks out wide to his brother Matt. He takes the mark and feeds out wide towards Phil Lobb. He goes back to Burkett, but there's the siren, three-quarter time. And the Polaris Financial Services scoreboard reads, Yendi? reads, Robsy 10-12-72, leading Broadford 6-11-47.
And the goal kick is to Sudbury Rec Reserve. Don't miss that one. It's going to be absolutely fantastic and off the hook. And a good friend, the unsung hero of 2015 in the RDFNL, Betty Watson, is running the show down there. So get around her and make sure you get down there and enjoy the day on the 10th of October.
Brady Holland just rolling towards half 40. They've got to kick the first one or two of this last quarter Broadford to have any hope.
They certainly do here on 100.7 Highlands FM, live and exclusive on this one here. It's the Redbacks kicking the Laurie Green Pavilion in, which has been the scoring in for much of the day, but we don't think the way that weather's had too much impact on this one. There's overcast and mildly sunny conditions at times have engulfed the day. We'll see a ball up just right of centre. So, of course, Romsey in the box seat. They're 25 points up. Looking forward to back-to-back home finals if the opportunity presents itself, as the Broadford guys should push forward again now. Right forward kick, looking up for Philpott. Can't quite bring it to ground. Good spoil there from his Romsey opponent. Comes out to Brady Holland, throws it on the boot. It goes through for a minor score. So,
again, really well done by Jimmy Carroll there. He's worked hard. He just sneaks in around into the front position and just knocks the ball out from underneath. And he's played that really well for most of today.
Even four goals the margin at the moment here, as Chris Burkett marks on half back on the Players Financial Services scoreboard, 6-12.
Beautiful
10-12.
Kick.
That was a great kick by Burkett. He didn't have much room to work with there.
Textbook to Romerall. Opponent shielding his eyes from the sun. Loops it out to Raymond, as the boys have said. Dynamic third term, back to Chris Burkett. Chris Burkett here for Romsey, former Lancefield star, tearing it up here on the big stage here in the prelim for the Redbacks, as it goes out towards Zach Sard. He should sell some candy to the boundary line and he'll kick a goal. Yes, he does! This guy is insane!
What?
5 goals the margin.
What a magnificent game he's having, and he just does the things that just a lot of us just dream about doing. Just fantastic stuff again, just elusive, getting around, and just a magnificent finish. And that's the perfect start for the Redbacks in this last quarter, pushing the margin beyond 5 goals. Now it's going to be really hard for Broadford.
And I'm going to disagree with you, EJ. A lot of us could dream, but we can't dream that extreme, so we don't. So we don't dare it. And then he goes out and does it anyway.
Yeah, no doubt.
Amazing, isn't it?
Yeah, he's certainly one of the stars of this league.
How many goals did he kick today?
That's just the second for Zach Sard, two to his brother Wally as well.
Ball will go up in the middle of the ground again. Benny Way up against Spark. Way will win it down to Matt Burkett, who just breaks a couple of tackles on the left foot inside forward 50. Deep inside forward 50, but Brad Mitchell's outmarked down there by Corey Vianney. Just nudged him under the football. Vianney now feeds the handball out to Reece Smith. Running off that half back line, he kicks towards the wing, and Josh Pound, leading Matt Burkett to the ball, takes the mark, centre wing. Looks inboard, tries to find Stevie Boyle. He takes the mark in front of Connor Whelan. Boyle now, it's a little bit stagnant ahead of the ball. as Pound goes on the left foot, kicks up towards half forward, just overcooks it a little bit. Raymond picks it up, clears the area, gives it to Petroro. He turns, Connor Whelan in space. Connor Whelan returns, inside 50, right foot, kick and goal!
Oh, nice, Harness.
Smith works back and gets his finger to it.
Well, he deserved that, didn't he?
He did. He's had an outstanding game today against two of the best ruckmen in the competition.
Polaris Financial Services scoreboard. It's now at 11-13-77 to 6-12-48.
As the ball goes inboard, finds Stevie Boyle again in the middle of the ground. Of course, he's had the ball on a ball on a string today. Goes over the top, finds his teammate there in Peduto. Peduto will look to square it up. Brody Holland coming through the middle of the ground, marks right in the middle of Lancefield Park. Holland, they're still stagnant, still chipping, still trying to work the ball in, but needs something to happen. Justin Webb picks the ball up, tries to kick inside 50. Petroro gets a smother and the Redbacks are away again.
Ball at half forward there as Feltham shrugs off his opponent there in Scales and pumps the ball along up towards centre half forward. Strong mark. There to Romsey, and this is Dawson.
It is.
Well, it cometh the man, cometh the moment. He chips the ball over the top. That's very good work.
Goal.
Fantastic work, and Dawson, he may not necessarily impact the score sheet today, but that's the second good thing that he's done in probably the last 15 minutes of play that he's set up his teammates for goals, and that's a crucial goal. That puts the margin out to 37 points on the Polaris Financial Services scoreboard. It's 10-13-85 to 6-12-48.
Good reward for Whelan there, as you mentioned. The early part of that third quarter when Spark was in there, he was setting his hands on the little ball a little bit, but Whelan really, against such a big opposition, he has really put in a fantastic effort today. Benway in the ruck at the start of this last quarter, he's having a big influence. He's getting his hands on the footy there. 37 points to margin. It's a long way back for Broadford.
Still yet a game high margin though. The margin was 40 points. It was brought back down to 14 in the third term as the ball's handball out towards Feltham here for Romsey. Handball's out now to Farmer. Hard up or close to the boundary line, just kicks straight through it. Unfortunately for him, misses to the near side. And we're 5 minutes gone here in this term. 38 points to margin. We spoke about it pre-game. If Broadford are in front within the 10-minute mark of the first term, that'll go a long way to winning a game because that's how they've set up the last two games. That wasn't the case. Romsey have yet to be headed all day.
Yeah, they're in control as Josh Pound will kick the ball out to half-back. Bryson Scales takes a strong mark. Feltham runs into him, but umpire paid the mark. Scales now, bright green boots again. Handball's off. Josh Pound kicks the ball out wide. Stevie Boyle will again get another possession. Boyle in short again to Pound. Pound holds the mark. And again, this has been the story of this last quarter though. Broadford have had to stop, start, short, chip the ball when really they need to attack and take the game.
Well, that's it. Boyle and Pound are getting a bit of the footy, but it's not in very dangerous positions.
As Pound puts it out on the foot.
That's the story of the day, Dougie.
We know the day's done then, don't we, Doug?
Yes, when it's Josh Pound as well that's making that mistake.
As Matt Burkett goes inboard, finds Brayden Feltham, who's been pretty good and been lively around that half-forward line for the Redbacks. Kicks inside forward 50, Dawson on the lead, lob comes in, has to be in the back, umpire says play on. Clearing kick out of there from Howes, goes out towards Grant Wern in a two-on-one, and Wern will get the free kick.
Free kick for a push there. The Polaris Financial Services scoreboard, it's 12-14-86. So 6-12-48, 38 points of margin. We're 6.5 gone here in this final term as Broadford maintain possession here. Almost to the Bronc cheers from Pound there. It didn't go over the line on the floor in that case there as Boyle over the head there. Bullis worked his man under the ball, left foot kick over the top now looking for Jake Hall. He marks strongly between wing and half forward. Broadford's attacking zone. Right foot kick. Rominak is the man in the gun there. Couldn't quite take the mark there against Romerall. As Bullis is wrapped up straight away there. Umpire says play on here as Heatherton tries to work his way out of traffic. Great work there from Romerall. Fantastic work, in fact. And it'll be a fitting boundary throw in here. And that it is.
And just Rominak had a really, an exceptional first half. And he's done a couple of good things in the second half, but really, Phil Romerall's curbed his influence.
Yeah, it took the word just right in my mouth there. Gav Romerall, he's done a really good job on him since quarter time, really, Phil Romerall. He's their number one lockdown defender. He's been a stalwart for Romsey for a number of years now, and he's done a really good job on him.
Benny Way will get the free kick for a hold out of the ruck contest. kicks up towards half forward, beautiful kick towards Feltham, who fumbles, and after that, there's going to be a free kick for a shove here. Braden Feltham will get, he fumbled the ball over the boundary line. It would have been a throw-in, but Bryson Scales just decided to give him a little shove afterwards, and Feltham will get this free.
That's frustration there, creeping abroad for their since their season, slipping away, ball at half back there, Reece Smith handballs now to Boyle, back out to Pound. How many times have we called those three today? Quite enormous, as Ben Way, source of the high heavens, attacks a mark. We've just ticked on 8 minutes, it's 38 points the margin here. Romsey led this one in the final term, led by as much as 40. Margin was cut back to 13 in the other third term here, as Connor Whelan, right foot kick up towards half forward. He's got a small target there in Dawson compared to who he was up against there. Couldn't quite take the mark. House there for Broadford across half back. Left foot kick looking for Holland, and he finds him. He had a shot at goal in the opening minute. Missed. If he had got it, game could be a different story. As Wern on the outer side finds a teammate in the clear, and they're looking to try and work their way up towards the middle of the ground here. House, the edge of the cricket pitch, handballs to a teammate under pressure in Webb, but they're peeled off well across the outer side. That's Wern, spearing kick up towards half forward, and another good mark, Dougie, by Romerill.
Yes, good. He got into the hole very well, and helping his teammate who was covering a Broadford opponent.
He's a real unsung hero for Romsey, Phil Romerill.
Ball out towards over the head of Jack O'Sullivan there for Romsey. He was as good as written off there with injury, and he recovers well. That was in the first term. He puts the ball long. Dawson will be the man to fly. And another strong mark taken there by Broadford. Go back with the fly to the play. It's a 9.5 gone, and we're a 38 points of margin, Gav.
And Michael House tries to clear out, but only gets as far as Brad Mitchell. He turns with the handball to Jack O'Sullivan, who pops a little kick inside forward 50, and Wally Sard takes a mark, plays on straight away, walks around his Broadford opponent, in. Straightens up, and misses everything, yes. And puts it on the floor.
His kicking hasn't been the greatest this afternoon, Wally. 2-3, and just pushing that one out of bounds as well, so that's something to be looking to tighten up for next week.
And EJ, you've been following the Heathcote District Footy League Grand Final.
Yeah, it's almost three-quarter time, and North Bendigo 9 points in front of Leechville Gunbower, but North have got two injuries, so they're down two rotations on the bench. And in the AFL, it's Fremantle 6-4, leading Sydney 2-11 nearing halftime.
Phenomenal scoring there as Broadford try to clear across half back. They need another one here. We've ticked on 10 minutes now, and they won't happen for them now, as Farmer, right foot kick inside the forward 50, looking for one of the Stard boys. That was Zach that went up. Broadford peel off now. Right foot kick over the top to Webb in front of Sullivan. Ball handballed out towards the boundary line, looking for Hall. Ball hits the deck. Romsey with some numbers around this contest now. Petroro, left foot kick along the boundary line now to Mitchell. Mitchell picks up for Romsey. Handball's in port to Jack O'Sullivan. And look at the young fella go. Can't believe he was playing under 16s this year, and he'll be playing in a senior grand final this year. And with poise like that, finding Dawson. And I think Dougie, with all that Dawson's done today and the way the team's gone, he should go back and kick this one.
Well, he's certainly got that opportunity, but I just want to make a comment about the Romsey team. We were talking before the game about pace and getting out into space, and I think Romsey have turned up trumps in that area today, and it's made a lot of difference to them. They're an enigmatic side, and they've had four good quarters of football today.
Well, they've completely dominated this last quarter, 9 inside 50-1, and Dawson with an opportunity to kick his first goal of the afternoon.
And should he kick this with the break in play, we'll go to Dougie for what's happening next week, as Dawson, he's got it on the Polaris Financial Services scoreboard. Romsey have kicked away now. They are 13-14, 92 to 6-12, 48 to a game high margin, 44 points. And Dougie, what's happening next week, mate?
Well, let's take the footy division and the under 18.5s. Rupert's will be playing Woodend Heskett. In the reserves, Diggers Rest will be playing Sunbury Kangaroos. And let's put it down as now that Diggers Rest will be playing Romsey in the seniors. And when you look at the netballers, well, we're looking at Rupertswood will be playing Riddle in the under-19s. In the C grade, Romsey will be playing Riddle. In the B grade netball, Rupertswood will be playing Lancefield. Well done, Lancefield. And in the A grade, Macedon will be playing Rupertswood.
Free kick in the middle of the ground. It's going to go to Connor Whelan from a block from Philpott. Whelan plays on, goes to Mitch Farmer. He goes long and deep inside forward 50 as we fly, as and it's Zach Sard. At least one of the Sards. I think it might even be Wally. while he's gone up taking the mark, this kick could go anywhere.
Well, we're about 150 metres away with a from this contest, so
they look pretty similar.
No, it is. Well, yep. He's kicked a few goals today.
Well, if he had to kick straight, he really probably should have kicked five or six today, Wally. So he's only managed the two so far, but this is 38 straight in front and really should be his third.
Well, Dawson kicked one from similar range just a few moments ago as we approach the 13-minute mark, and this is to put the margin out to 50 points on the run. You just about put this in on from a set shot. You could do the same thing. 50 points it is to the Redbacks. It's 14-14, 98 to 6-12, 48. We have 13 minutes and change gone in this final term. And Saad, I think he becomes the leading goal kicker of the game for Romsey with three goals.
Indeed, and some good reward there because he really has been so dangerous inside the forward 50 today, Wally, along with his brother Zach. And three goals is a good return. And certainly, if they're going to knock off Diggers Rest next week, they're going to need those Saad boys up and about.
Well, it's just phenomenal. At 14-minute mark of the second, the third term, it was 13 points of margin. Since then, the Redbacks have gone on and kicked the last six goals of this contest to basically end it right there and then. And we thought Philpott was going to take the game away with four goals. Gav,
as they come out of the middle now with Stevie Boyle, he gets a handball out, but Connor Whelan picks it up. Boyle gets a smother. Brody Holland leads the race for the football. Swings around on the left boot. Pops it over the top. Boyle gets into a bit of space. He handballs off to Bullis. Bit stagnant. Chris Burkett chases him down, but he gets his kick inside forward 50. Philpott, too big, too strong. Takes the mark. 15 metres out.
Too
slight
good.
Ankle.
Well, we just spoke about him just a few moments ago.
He was actually the catalyst for the Redbacks' last run. Really, when he missed that goal from about 3 metres out.
Exactly right.
Yeah, absolutely. He had the mismatch down there inside forward 50, and there was always only going to be one result. Just reached over the top and grabbed it, and a chance to kick his fourth goal of the afternoon.
Momentum is a funny thing, and Philpott's miss at the 14-minute mark of the second term has been one-way traffic since then. Question of accuracy.
Oh.
He's missed to the cheers of the Romsey faithful. Back to 49 points. So double their score now, 49 to 98. So it's certainly been a long time between drinks here for Brawford. They'll be going through the motions now, unfortunately.
Yeah, it's been pretty comprehensive as the Redbacks kick the ball out wide towards Phil Lobb. Had a bit of it today, still hasn't been his dominant best, but starting to get his hands on it, which will be good signs for the Redbacks. Matt Burkett looks to centre forward. This kid's been absolutely outstanding. Connor Whelan marks the ball 55 metres out from goal, looks inside 50, just pops it in front of Wally Saad. He leads out, takes the mark on his chest, and he'll go back and have a shot for his fourth. No, he'll pass off to Phil Lobb, who got into space. He just props, he puts it towards goal, and he misses.
Is Connor Whelan a contender?
I think in Gavin's view, yes.
I think Gav's view, Connor's got the wine.
No, I wouldn't give it to Connor, actually, but I think he's been outstanding. Yeah, to go up against those two guys, they're man mountains. And
yeah, he's
Connor
really
Whelan's a kid.
Yep.
And it's just been a fantastic performance.
Of course, the Saads have got to mention Wally particularly, a lot of mention.
And Zach Saad has just been dealing with the Brawford defence attack all day. A switch. Switch there from Brawford, went out of bounds.
Oh, Zach's got the shot on goal. This could be interesting. No, I think today for me, Jimmy Carroll's been outstanding down back. I know that Philpott's kicked three when he's been down there, but Jimmy's well and truly undersized down there. And Brad Mitchell's been phenomenal, and so's Chris Burkett.
Oh, yes. Zach Saad, bends back. And he just snuck it through for a minor score.
Yes, Chris Burkett has been able to open up the game several times. He's been able to also find the space, but he's got wonderful speed and good foot skills.
Yeah, and three-quarter time in the Heathcote League. It is North Bendigo 58, leading Leechville 50 by 8 points.
So that's a low-scoring tight encounter as Bromsey goes straight back into the forward line. Now, strong mark! Is that Benny Way?
Benny Way, big and strong.
And he's had a good second half.
He has. His tail has been up today. His form has probably been down a little bit in recent weeks, and he'll be the first to acknowledge that. And he'll go back and kick his second goal today, thanks to Polaris Financial Services at the 17-minute mark to put the margin back out to 57 points and put them over the ton. He's done that, just that, Benny Way. And it's party time here for the Redbacks. 17 and a quarter minutes gone here in this term. And it's 6-13-49 to 14-16 100? No.
106.
106, there we go, mate. 15, oh, they're five 16. Goals, not four.
15, 16, 106.
That's a bit, and all of us here, we don't have access to a single scoreboard at this stage. That's our mantra for today. Yeah. But
and Wade was a real important in the start of this last quarter. He started the ruck for the first 5 or 6 minutes, and he's getting his hands on there.
He just
pushing
killed the game
as well. Yeah, exactly right. And put it beyond doubt. And no doubt at all now that it's going to be the Redbacks taking on the Burrows next Sunday.
Yeah, and well done to Romsey for the way they've come out and played today. I thought Broadford would be much closer than this.
Stevie Boyle comes storming out of the middle, puts it long, and again, poor old Jimmy Carroll, undersized down there. They just sat it on Philpott's head, and he takes a nice strong mark against Jimmy Carroll, who's given his all, and it's probably unfortunate if his opponent ends up with four goals.
Oh, it is, yeah, and I guess it's a bit of a tale from Broadford as well. If they'd have been able to get the ball inside 50 enough, one-on-one to Philpott, he's proven that he's virtually almost impossible to stop with the size down there. So.
And he's on one leg too.
Yeah, look, I don't think he was 100% fit, definitely. He hasn't spent that much time in the ruck today. No. The crowd, the Romsey fans right in front of us, absolutely loving it.
And, of course, one factor is the fact that he's not 100% fit. And when you think about kicking and so on and where he's has his injury, it's...
He's never been the greatest kick at goal, to be honest.
Yes, well, maybe James. It's not being helped even today, because two chances there which should have been straightforward.
Chris Burkett there for Romsey. It's back to 56 points the margin, 106 to 50. Says Nathan Dazari, dishes the handball up now to Braden Felton, knocks it down, is taken there by Brady Holland there of Broadford. Back to Pacciuto, intercepted there by Jack Mills. Gets on his right foot, into space there for Nathan Dazari, and he's got chance, he's got Stevie Boyle hot on his hammer, forced the turnover here. Broadford, left foot kick up towards Holland for Broadford. On centre wing commentary side, loops it over to Bullis. And a strong mark there in front of Patterson, who's tried hard all day. Bullis, left foot kick, up towards that boy again. Much better.
Well, they just don't have anybody really to man up on him at the moment. Yeah. And with the game gone, there's no real need for Dean Helmers to throw someone back there. He's getting plenty of opportunities, Philpott. Yes. But he's not making the most of
it. Because he's copying an absolute bait.
Yeah, I'll be interested to see his reaction if he kicks it.
Yeah, well, he's had a bit of lip in the last couple of minutes with someone behind the goals.
Behind the goals, there's been a conversation going on behind the goals.
Certainly is a bit of verbals happening.
And he'll still get cheered if he kicks it as well by the Romsey faithful. Yeah, you can hear Romsey go absolutely off their rocket, but that's footy. That's one of the things we love about it. No harm in that whatsoever. Back to 15 points. It's 7-14, 56 to 15-16, 106.
And of course, Jimmy Philpott, standout player for the Middle District Football Netball League in the interleague game against the Nepean Football League. I think he was in the top of the best players.
Yeah, was he dominating the ruck?
My memory's correct.
Yeah, four goals is a pretty good return from inside the forward 50.
Yeah, 4-3,
two. Yeah, and as we go back, is that one he missed sort of halfway through that third quarter where the game really turned right into Romsey's favour after that.
And the Redbacks will get a free kick out of the middle here, which will go to Connor Whelan for a centre square infringement. Whelan will look to drive the Redbacks back inside forward 50. They want a bit of party time here towards Benny Way. Nobody really flies. The Redbacks are sort of stopped now, conserving for next week possibly, as Holland wins the ball into the middle. Vianney comes through the middle with a bounce, kicks out towards half forward. Bullis running back with the flight of the ball. Is that Hall? No, it's Bullis. Bullis turns, kicks it high onto the head of Philpott again. He flies, he shoves his opponent out. Nathan Dazari will take a free kick. And it's going to be a 50. Because Philpott picked the ball up, and then because he's hurt his finger by
the standard on the old finger breaker there.
Yeah, I think the fingers touched, got the ball. It didn't go right in the hand.
Ball.
And that we all know that hurts.
So he's just dropped the ball on the ground after realising that he dislocated his finger. And free kick goes to Zari, who squares it up out wide towards Cam Dawson.
You're on half back here for their Redbacks. Usually used to seeing him at half forward. Finds Feltham. He's got Chris Burkett all alone. Probably a little bit too cute with that one there. Kicking into Pacciuto. Ricochets out of bounds. And if he had hit up Burkett, he could have jogged a 50 and kicked. I had another shot at goal. But again, both teams going through the motions. 22 minutes gone in this term. And we've seen six goals kicked for this guy in this final term. As Romsey handball up towards the corridor. They've got a few numbers here. Romerall. Back now to Dawson. You can see Matt Burkett behind plays, just cramping up a bit.
The ball swings out wide towards Jack O'Sullivan. does not look out of place a single bit in this senior lineup. He swings the ball out to Mark Young, who goes inside 50, lob leading up in the football, getting his hands on it. Good signs for the Redbacks. Lob now inside forward 50, just pops it up, looking for a flyer. Benny Way flew. Ball hits the deck, didn't quite get his hands on it. Feeds out towards the Broadford Roos now as they'll kick up to centre back and a relieving mark for Mark Peduto.
Yeah, Mark Peduto has the ball across half back, switches across the outer side. It's nearly 23 minutes gone, 50 points of margin in favour of the Redbacks, 106 to 56. And the ball goes out of bounds, we'll see a throwing out of side.
Yeah, with 23 minutes gone, I'm sure that anybody has a little bit of a niggle at all. Dean Elmers will be bringing him off the ground now because the Redbacks certainly have locked their place into the grand final next week. So we certainly wouldn't be taking a risk with anybody as they burst away from the clearance again.
Through Young, pumps the ball along towards the top of the square. They'll get a goal here, Romsey. Oh, they won't. The kick under pressure.
There's no one queuing up to come off, EJ.
They all seem to be queuing up to kick a goal, though.
Yes, that's right. And just talking before about the Interleague, and I noticed that in the Nepean, who the Riddle Issue Football League played this year, Rosebud has gone through to the grand final, and the preliminary final being played today is between Somerville and Sorrento.
So that'll be an absolute cracker. Now on the Ballarat Footy League, Daly made it through last week. They'll await their opponents today. There'll be a big game next Saturday afternoon as Nathan Dazari marks across half back here for Romsey, looking for Chris Burkett. What a game he's had.
Yes, he's in my best six.
Oh, easily, and it's fitting because he wears number six as well. Just yes. To make things interesting now, he finds a Feltham who's probably had 8 to 10 touches in this final term at least.
Yeah, he's had a pretty good game all round today, Feltham.
Yeah, just working his way back into form. Felton, right foot kick inside the 450. Away!
Who marks? Beautiful extension, taking the mark at the highest point. Always tough for a defender to stop.
Just a perfect kick, though, there from Felton. Just popped it in front of him and allowed Benny Way to jump at the side.
Beautifully weighted.
Yes. And if you look just at halves, in that second half, Ben's right up there, actually. As I mentioned in the third quarter, I like the way he was finding space and he was following through. I think he was giving his teammates plenty of opportunities and he was getting possessions.
And lining up for his third goal.
These guys that have had pretty quiet weeks here for Romsey in recent weeks, they've stepped up as Ben Way misses to the near side. And that's been the intriguing part. I guess Dawson's done a few nice things. Lobb's done a few nice things. Way, just a handful of guys there for the Redbacks who have had a pretty quiet final series by their standards.
And with a couple of guys to come back in, it'll be interesting to see what happens on the selection table for the Redbacks this week.
Well, will their captain come back into the team there, Gav?
Well, he was right on the borderline this week, apparently, and they sort of said to him, if you come back in, you're going to have to ruck and help out. And he went, well, I don't think I'm right to do that. And they went, well, if you're not right to do that, you don't play. So good decision by the Redbacks there. It's if he's on the borderline, he might be a chance as Farmer goes long inside forward 50. And just sitting behind the ball, cleaning up there, is Michael Howes.
26 minutes gone here in this term. 52 points the margin here. Not the game high. The game high was 57 points about 8 minutes ago. As Broadford, well, their work in this final series has to be admired, doesn't it? They've knocked over two premiership favourites in consecutive weeks to make this game. And Romsey have had to play at their best to win today.
Oh, without question. I mean, to make it to a prelim final is an outstanding performance from Broadford. And
from sixth position too.
Yeah, absolutely. And they knocked over two quality football sides, but they've just been outclassed today.
O'Sullivan pumps the ball along inside the forward line there for Romsey. Broadford trying to work their way out. Zach Sard lays the tackle and it'll be a ball up as pressure seconds tick away. 52 points of margin.
O'Sullivan's had a really big last quarter. He's got plenty of the footy, young Jack.
As Whelan wins the not hit out down, it goes down towards Zach Sard again, check side across the body, just misses.
How many points has he kicked today?
That's 2 goals, 4 now for Zach Sard and 3-3 for Wally, so 5-7 between them.
That is frightening.
Broadford's been a bit of a journeyman. When they go from one league to another league, they came back in the Riddle District Football League in 2009. They've had to get around a fair bit, and it's good that they rejoined again this year after thinking about getting to the Kyabram District Footy League.
They've come back and just trying to suss out the word around how Kilmore's going this year, and they're going to do the best thing that's right for the club. There's a number of issues there, and hopefully the best outcome eventuates, and for our sake, hopefully they stay in the RDFNL as Romsey intercept the clearance there for Broadford up towards Brad Mitchell there at centre half forward.
And as was mentioned in the Sports Wrap program last night, Kilmore, a change there. So if that proceeds, and if Kilmore is accepted in the other league, well, we're back to 12 clubs and not the bye.
Ball inside the Romsey forward line now. Broadford with the ball up towards Petudo. At centre-half back, plays on now. Handball over the top there of Mitchell. Handball at the, I think it was the Pound's ankles. And it's taken here by Mark Young there for Romsey. Inside the forward 50 again. They haven't stopped all game, Romsey. They've just kept going and going. And we'll see a boundary throw in.
They've been completely dominant in this last quarter. 19 inside 50s for the Redbacks to just 6 for Broadford.
Fellas, remember a couple of years ago, the Interleague and Elberton won, beat us by a point. I noticed the grand final today over there is the two clubs that are always up the top, Dalston and Fish Creek, are playing the grand final over in the Elberton League today.
Great paddle. Clear the ball out to the wing. Corey Hall takes the mark. Squares back up to Stevie Boyle again, who popped, or Brody Holland pops it back over. Corey Hall takes the mark. Centre wing. There's all the sting out of this one. Romsey through to a grand final next week against Diggers Rest in a replay of last year. As Jack Mills takes the mark, plays on, goes deep inside forward 50. Benny Way flies. Ball hits the deck. Way recovers. Handballs out to Nathan Tazari. Nathan Tazari goes bang. And a fantastic goal. And a great way to put the emphasis on what is a great performance today.
Yeah, good reward for Nathan Tazari there. He's been good across halfback and just drifting forward there to finish one off. We're just going through the motions here now. The Redbacks know they've got a date with the Diggers Rest side again next week to try and get some revenge after last week. They knocked them off by 21 points in the second semi-final. And in the Heathcote League, we're 10 minutes into the last quarter and it is North Bendigo 9-11-65 leading Leechville Gunbower 7-9-51.
And it's 114-55 here at Lanceville Park. Romsey running away with it. We've ticked on 29 and a quarter minutes into this term. It's 6-1 for the quarter, so I can't imagine there'd be too much time on left in this this final stanza. Rucks go up again. Whelan wins it down to ground now, and Broadford looking to try and gather a clearance there through Romanek. He's in there in support. Wern to Holland. It's back to Boyle. All have played their role today, unfortunately.
Yeah. Boyle, I think, best player for Broadford.
Certainly right there, Dougie, as Corey Hall brings the ball inside the forward line. Look for Heather, and he marks in front of Tazari. A save from a... Well, he'll loop the ball over the top here to Petudo. We'll set... The first game of the today, 5 points in favour of the Hawks, getting up in a thriller. And then we've gone from, was it a 70-point margin, and now we're at 59 points. So probably hasn't been the most exciting day of footy, really.
Jeez, there's been some highlights, though. Some of the things, like watching Zach Sard running around out here.
Yeah, it's been absolutely electric, some of the things he's done this afternoon.
It's been good to see him out there and at his best today for the Redbacks. And we've seen some flies from Benny Way and...
And a goal here
Pedudo
from Petudo.
Petudo goes through and puts through a goal.
Chip clipped the post, man, I think.
Yes, it's a behind.
Oh, it's a behind. Yeah. We're 30 minutes into this last quarter, is that right?
Yeah, that's what we've got here.
You may wonder why we haven't mentioned the Bendigo Football Netball League. Well, they've got lights up there at Curio Oval, and of course the earlier games have been played, but the 6 o'clock start for the main game is between Strathfield Say and Golden Square. What a top game that'll be.
As Mills knocks the ball down, and a little bit of pressure, but Jimmy Carroll comes across, forces the ball towards that half back line. Grant Wern goes around the body, inside forward 50, Pound in a 3-on-1.
And
we got a free kick.
Just going back.
Against Corey Hall here by the looks of it, or against Brody Holland here by the looks of it. It'll go to Jack Mills.
Back to where the kick had come from. Mills finds O'Sullivan out there on the outer wing. We've ticked into the, well and truly into the 32nd minute here on Highlands FM.
Chris, has it been a hard game to umpire today?
Oh, look, I think it's been pretty self-explanatory. It got headed at times and it got stamped right out of the game.
Early on the first quarter, of course, it was man-to-man, wasn't it? A lot of goings on there, and the umpires had to keep control.
Well, it had to be Michael O'Keefe. He's got to pick two of these umpires next week, from all reports, to go up, so to join Dwayne Connell in the seniors. So it's going to be a fantastic well-umpire game, but these boys have done very well, as Chris Burkett marks across half-back, and they'll do it!
Well, Romsey, they've done well. They have got through to the grand final. and they will be playing for Diggers Rest, who have been waiting for the winner of this game, and undoubtedly on the scoring board, on the field, that winner was Romsey.
Yeah, fantastic performance from the Redbacks. They get over the line this afternoon, and the goal kick is for Romsey as Yendi tries to head down and find some interviews for us. Wally Sard with three, Zach Sard and Ben Wade two apiece, one each to Dawson, Mitchell, Chris Burkett, Petoro, Feltham, Farmer, Matt Burkett, Whelan and Nathan Tazari. So a big spread of goals there for the Redbacks. And for Broadford, four to Big Philpott, one each to Boyle, Littlewood and Hall. But a comprehensive win for Romsey. They move on to the grand final next Sunday at their home ground of Romsey Park, where they're going to take on Diggers Rest Burrows, who are going to be looking to end a long, long drought without a premiership.
Yes, and have we got the actual scores? Is that we have difficulty?
16-19, 1-15 to 7-15-57.
So, a bit slower. 16-19?
Yep, that's the one, mate. So 16-19, 1-15 to 7-15-57. So a 58-point win there,
so
of course.
Chris.
And for those who are just tuning in, we've been tucked up in here in the old scoreboard box. So we've had no view whatsoever. We can see the scoreboard, but we can't see the figures, the digits.